Today's presentation talks about the number representation. If you talk about memory, memory is an 8-bit memory, or memory is a 16-bit memory, or memory is a 32-bit memory. So our memory, what we have with 8051 microcontroller is 8-bit memory. But there is a possibility for us to store 16-bit number in 2 bytes. Least significant byte first, most significant byte next. So the memory that what we have with respect to 8051 microcontroller is 8-bit memory, whether the program memory or data memory, both are 8-bit memory. The size of the memory, which can go up to 64 KB, that is different. So one with in one address, 8 locations are the 8 bits can be stored. So hence it is called as 8-bit memory. For example, if it is a program memory, 0000 memory location can hold only 8 bit. If it is a data memory, 00 memory location can hold only 8 bit. Whether it is a program memory or data memory, it can store only 8 bit. So that too in binary. So memory can store only binary numbers. Okay, so today it's a very interesting topic where we can celebrate a lot by looking at this, because these are all the things which we have already studied in the digital electronics. So the same thing I'm going to do it in different way. The title for this slide given is number representation. So how to represent the number in a particular memory, or how to view that number, is the prime objective of this presentation. Viewing the memory content as hexadecimal content, decimal content, how it is unsigned content, unsigned character, signed character, unsigned integer, signed integer, unsigned long integer, and signed long integer, like this. Okay, it's very interesting. So get ready to play the quiz. Let the first question: how to represent 7 in 3-bit binary? 111. Oh, very good. Coming to the second question: how to represent 0 in 3-bit binary? How to represent -1 in 3-bit binary? Now it's very interesting. 1 in binary is 100. Oh, Rajkumar is saying 111. Saranya is saying 111. But Abhida Kumari says 100. Oh, here there is confusion. Someone of you are saying 111. Someone of you are saying 100. Okay, let us see. Oh, it's very interesting, right? How to represent -2 in 3-bit binary to make it much more clear? Can you answer this question? Raj Kishore 110, Vignesh 110, Saranya 110, Karishma 110. So -2 is 110. All are very much comfortable. How to represent -4 in 3-bit binary? Raj Kishore says 101. How to represent -0 in 3-bit binary? Raj Kishore is giving 000. -0 is represented as 000. Rajkumar is saying -0 and +0 both are same, sir. There is nothing like -0 and +0. But Purnima, Kausika, and Sankarapriya, Danumita, they are giving 000 answers. Someone of you giving 100. Vignesh is giving 100. -0 is 100. Fantastic. Different answers. And Saranya, Shalini, Ashwat, all are giving 000 as an answer. Now the next question. In C programming, the range of unsigned characters 0 to 255. Fantastic, right? Purnima, Vignesh, Saranya, Karishma. Now try to answer the next question. In C programming, the range of signed characters -128 to +127. Okay, try to answer the next question. The range of unsigned integers 0 to Lakshana, 0 to 68,535, very good. Chiranjeevi, 0 to 68,535. Karishma, 0 to 68,535. Okay, now the next question in C programming. The range of signed integers, Sandhya is saying -32,768 to +32,760. Try to answer this question. In C programming, the range of unsigned long integers. Okay, long integer means, is it 32 bit or 62 bit? 64 bit. Okay, long integer means it is 64-bit representation. In C programming, the range of signed long integer, it is very big. Okay, we can leave the choice. Okay, very good. Congratulations and appreciations to all. Great, you have refreshed all the interesting thing. Now going to the concepts, right? Let me do some simple activity here. Let me put it 000, 3-bit binary. 001, 010 is 2. Then next number is 011 is 3, and next number is 100 is 4, 101 is 5, 110 is 6, 111 is 7. You see, a representing an unsigned number means we can say that this is 0 and this is 1 and this is 2 and this is 3 and this is 4 and this is 5 and this is 6 and this is 7. Fantastic. Now, signed representation, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Now I am facing some trouble. How do I fill this 4 column, please? Someone of you can help me to fill this 4 rows. What should I type here? All of you are able to see the cursor in the screen. And Rajkumar is saying minus 0. Let me put it as minus 0. Harita is saying minus 2. Let me put it as minus 2. Rajkumar is saying minus 4 in 2's complement. So whatever you say, I will just keep on typing, right? Minus 4. With respect to Rajkumar, it is minus 4. So there are three answers for the fifth row. Second column, one answer is minus 0, another answer is minus 2, another answer is minus 4. 100 in 3-bit binary is dash, is the question where we are getting so many answers. Ajay, minus 0 or minus 1? Okay, there is another one more. I got one more answer, minus 1. So 100 in 3-bit binary, when we look it as a signed number, there are several answers coming. Minus 0 is one answer, minus 1 is another answer, minus 2 is another answer. Minus 4 is another answer. Anyway, we are going to get right answer. But before getting the right answer, give your opinion. That is more important. Jay Surya plus 4 and soldier. 101 in 3-bit binary, when it is represented in the form of signed representation, it is minus 3 in solitang. Minus 3 in solitang. Okay, let it be minus 3. There is another answer called minus 1. Minus 1 soldranga, minus 3 soldranga. Okay, 110 in binary. So, எல்லாரும் மைனஸ் த்ரீ அல்லது மைனஸ் ஒன் சொல்லிட்டீங்க. இந்த மாதிரி 110 வந்து மைனஸ் டூ சொல்றீங்க. அண்ட் ஃபைனலி லாஸ்ட் ரோ செகண்ட் காலம் 111 மைனஸ் ஒன் மைனஸ் த்ரீ. இது இப்படியே வச்சுக்கலாம், நம்ம இந்த ஸ்கிரீன்ல இப்படியே வச்சுக்கலாம். இப்போ ஆன்சர் பார்க்கறதுக்கு நம்ம போகலாம். இப்போ வெரி இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் பாருங்க, மூணு பிட்ல எவ்வளோ கன்ஃபியூஷன்ஸ் பாருங்க நமக்கு. கரெக்டா இல்லையா? நம்ம 8 பிட்ல நம்ம 64 பிட் ப்ராசஸர்ல ஒர்க் பண்றோம். இந்த மூணு பிட்ல இப்போ நம்ம விளையாண்டு பார்த்துக்கிட்டு 3 பிட் தரவாயிட்டோம்னா 32 பிட் தரவாயிரும், 64 பிட் தரவாயிரும். தட் இஸ் த பிரைம் அப்ஜெக்டிவ் ஆஃப் திஸ் கேம், ஆஃப் திஸ் குவிஸ் காம்படிஷன். சார் எங்களுக்கு 6 - 2 = 4 தெரியாமையா சார்? நாங்கள் பிளஸ் டூவில் 200 வாங்கணும் மேக்ஸில். ஸோ த அப்ஜெக்டிவ் ஹியர் இஸ் வி ஆர் டூயிங் சப்ராக்ஷன் பை த்ரூ அடிஷன். தட் இஸ் த பிரைம் அப்ஜெக்டிவ். ஸோ பை டேக்கிங் டூஸ் காம்ப்ளிமெண்ட் அண்ட் ஆட் த நம்பர் பை டூயிங் அடிஷன், வி ஆர் டூயிங் சப்ராக்ஷன்ங்கிறது இந்த ஸ்க்ரீன் இருந்து நம்ம அப்ஜெக்டிவ் நம்ம புரிய போகிறோம். ஸோ 6 - 2 அப்படிங்கிறது 4-bit பைனரியில் நம்ம சொன்னோம்னா, லுக் அட் தி ஸ்க்ரீன், 6 - 2 இந்த 4-bit பைனரி கீஸை, 6 இஸ் ரெப்ரசன்டட் அஸ் 0110 அண்ட் 2 இஸ் ரெப்ரசன்டட் அஸ் 0010 அண்ட் வி சப்ராக்ட் திஸ் ரைட் ஆன்சர் இஸ் 0100 இன் 4-bit பைனரி. பட் ஹவு த ALU பெர்ஃபார்ம்ஸ் இன் எனி மைக்ரோ ப்ராசஸர்? ஸோ வி வில் டேக் த செகண்ட் நம்பர் விச் ஹேஸ் டு பி சப்ராக்டட். So we have to take the ones complement of it. So the ones complement of the second number 2 is 1101 in 4-bit. And we have to take the 2's complement of it. So adding 1 to this 1101 is 2's complement. And the 2's complement of 2 is 1110. So the subtraction is done by adding the 6 with 2's complement of 2. Hence, we are getting the answer as 10100. That means 0100 and we are getting the carry. So the carry denotes it is a positive number. Hence we are discarding the carry and then we are getting the answer as 0100. So 6 - 2 is 4. Here you can see 6 - 2 is 4. If you are highlighting, it's very interesting. So we are getting the subtraction answer through addition. It's very interesting. So subtraction answer through addition. That is what the beauty of this binary addition, right? That is why arithmetic logic on it. We have only adders within the microprocessor. By doing 2's complement addition, we do subtraction. By doing repeated addition, we do multiplication. By doing repeated subtraction, we do division. So with 1's and 0's, we can perform only addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. All the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division is being done only with the help of adder. Hence, full adders are the processing elements inside the microprocessor to perform arithmetic operations. Fantastic, right? And as we all know, logic gates itself is performing the logical operations. Hence, ALU is the processing element inside the processor. Beyond everything, The gates are the processing elements. The gates as well as the full layers are the main processing elements if you look at in depth. Okay, so this is very interesting. All of you know this very well. Going to the next problem. 6 minus 7 is minus 1. If we do this problem, we will get the answer now. That's all. And we will get the correct answer, and then we can fill that column in a much better way. As usual, 6 minus 7, 0, 1, 1, 0 is 6, 0, 1, 1, 1 is 7, and minus 1, 6 minus 7 is minus 1. Here it is given as 1, 1, 1, 1. Let us see how we are getting 1, 1, 1, 1. So the number to be subtracted is 7. So we have to take the 2's complement of this 7. So 1's complement of 7 is 1, 0, 0, 0, and adding 1 to 1, 0, 0, 0, we will get 1, 0, 0, 1. 2's complement of 7 is 1, 0, 0, 1. Adding this with 6, adding this with the number 6, we will get 1, 1, 1, 1. 0 plus 1 is 1, and 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, and 1, 0 plus 1 is 1, and there is no carry here because there is no carry, there is no bar carry. We can say that it is a negative number, hence we are putting a. So from this discussion, we are very clear about the negative number. So minus 1 is 1, 1, 1. So all 1s are minus 1. In 3-bit binary, 3 1s are minus 1. In 4-bit binary, 4 1s are minus 1. In 8-bit binary, 8 1s are minus 1. In 16-bit binary, 16 1s are minus 1. In 32-bit binary, 32 1s are minus 1. In 64-bit binary, 64 1s are minus 1. So all 1s are minus 1. That is the moral of the story. To make it much more clear, right? So as usual, the subtraction is happening by repeated addition. Hence, we are getting both the answers. Both the answers are same. Directly, if you subtract, we are getting the same answer by taking 2's complement, and we are also getting the same answer. This is fantastic, right? So subtraction is happening through 2's complement addition inside the microprocessor. That is what the moral. And if we do one more problem, still we will get more comfortable. So 5 minus 7 is minus 2. So minus 1, all of us are somewhat clear. Minus 2, if you know the which is minus 2, then all of us will understand 100% clearly. You can see 5 minus 7 is minus 2. So the binary equivalent of 5 is 0101, and the binary equivalent of 7 is 0111. And when you subtract, the minus 2 is 1110. How 1110? Let us see. Take the 7 and take the 2's complement of 7, which is 1000, and adding 1. It is taking 1's complement of 7 is 1000, adding 1, it is 2's complement is 1001, and adding the 2's complement of 7 with the 5, we will get 1110, and 1110 is minus 2. So 1110 is minus 2, here 1110 is minus 2. So we are doing a subtraction by 2's complement addition. Now very clear. So 1111 in 4-bit binary is minus 1. 1110 in 4-bit binary is minus 2. Like this, it goes on. Now we are very much clear. Shall we go and fill the column? What is the last row? எல்லா தப்பு தப்பா நான் பண்ணி வச்சிருக்கிறேன், எனக்கு ஹெல்ப் பண்ணுங்க. நான் கரெக்ட் ஆன்சர் பண்றதுக்கு. அப்போ 111 இன் 3-bit பைனரி இஸ் மைனஸ் 1. 100% கிளியர். சோ வாட் அபவுட் 110 இன் பைனரி? மைனஸ் 2. ஃபேண்டாஸ்டிக். தேங்க்ஸ் ஃபார் ஹெல்பிங் மீ இன் கரெக்டிங் மை மிஸ்டேக் இன் மை ஸ்லைடு. இந்த 101 பைனரியில் நான் ஏதாவது நிறைய டைப் பண்ணி வச்சிருக்கிறேனே, எனக்கு கரெக்ட் பண்ணுங்க பார்க்கலாம். 101 என்னங்க? மைனஸ் 3. தேங்க்யூ, ஐ ஹவ் கரெக்டட் மை மிஸ்டேக். இந்த 100 எனக்கு பயங்கர கன்ஃபியூஸா இருக்குது. 100 என்னங்க? அது ஒரு முடிவு ஏதோ சொல்லிடுங்க. 100 இன் பைனரி இஸ் மைனஸ் 4. விக்னேஷ், அஜய், மைனஸ் 4. சரி, இவ்வளோ பேர் மைனஸ் 4 சொல்றாங்க. லெட் மீ கரெக்ட் மை மிஸ்டேக். இட் இஸ் மைனஸ் 4. ஸோ வாட் இஸ் த மாரல் ஆஃப் திஸ் டிஸ்கஷன்? ஆல் ஒன்ஸ் ஆர் மைனஸ் 1. வெதர் இட் இஸ் அ 3-bit பைனரி, வெதர் இட் இஸ் அ 4-bit பைனரி, அதர் இட் இஸ் அன் 8-bit பைனரி, ஆர் 16-bit பைனரி, ஆர் 32-bit பைனரி. கிரேட். ஸோ வென் வி ஆர் இட் இஸ் அப் டு த யூசர்ஸ் வியூ. கம்ப்யூட்டருக்குள்ள இந்த 8 நம்பர் தான் இருக்குது. ஒரு 3-bit பைனரியில 8 பாசிபிள் காம்பினேஷன் தான் இருக்கும். இஃப் தெர் ஆர் 3 பிட்ஸ், ஒன்லி 8 பாசிபிள் காம்பினேஷன்ஸ். இஃப் யூ ஆர் வியூவிங் தட் 8 பாசிபிள் காம்பினேஷன்ஸ் ஆஸ் அன்சைன்டு நம்பர், த ரேஞ்ச் இஸ் ஃப்ரம் 0 to 7. இஃப் யூ ஆர் வியூவிங் தட் நம்பர் ஆஸ் அ சைன்டு நம்பர், the range is from minus 4 to plus 3. It is not that one negative number is greater than the positive number. because zero comes under positive number, hence it looks like negative number is one greater than the positive number. So how to differentiate whether it is a positive number or negative number? The only way is by looking at the most significant bit. Look at the screen. So as long as the most significant bit is zero, we can consider that as a positive number. As long as the most significant bit is one, we can consider that as a negative number. If it is an 8-bit binary, the 8th bit is considered as a signed bit. If it is 16-bit binary, 16-bit is considered as a signed bit. It is for our understanding. It is for us to understand. But within the processor, it is only 111. For example, 111 is there in the processor. Means this 111 can be viewed as a 7 or it can be viewed as a minus 1. It is up to the user's view. If you are viewing as a signed number, 111 is equal to minus 1. If you are viewing the same number as a unsigned number, that has to be considered as 7. So the content of the memory remains same, 1111, that is 111 only. How do we view that? If you view that number as unsigned number, its equivalent is 7. If you view that number as signed number, it is equal to minus 1. With the confident in 3-bit binary, let me jump to the 4-bit binary to make us much more comfortable. Now it is 4-bit binary. Fantastic, right? So 4-bit binary can be represented in the hexadecimal. Yes, in 3-bit binary, both hexadecimal and decimal numbers are same. But in 4-bit binary, the new column comes, which is hexadecimal number. Up to 7, both binary and hexadecimal remain same. And the unsigned number as well, decimal signed number, all remain same. But coming from the bottom, all ones are minus 1. That we are very clear. So let us make it as all ones are minus 1 in the last row. In hexadecimal, if it is 4-bit binary, it is represented as F. But if it is considered as an unsigned decimal number, then we can say it is 15. But when it is considered as a signed number, this 4 ones is minus 1. Now we are 100% clear. And the previous number is 1110, which is E in hexadecimal, which is viewed as an unsigned number, means it is 14. When 1110 is viewed as a signed number, means it is minus 2. Similarly, this is D is minus 3 when it is viewed as a signed number. D is plus 13 when it is viewed as an unsigned number. Similarly, it goes on like this. C means 12 if it is unsigned, but when it is viewed as a signed number, means it is minus 4. So this is very interesting. Okay, like this, all the columns are there. So when it is 4-bit binary, the range if it for unsigned decimal number is 0 to 15. For the signed number means minus 8 to plus 7. Hexadecimal, we can represent it as 0TF. Now you are much clear. Like this, when we jump to the 8-bit binary, this is how. So 8 zeros to 8 1. So there are 256 combinations. When it is 8-bit binary, for as a human, it is very difficult for us to represent everything in binary 1000000. Instead of saying that, it is better to use the hexadecimal representation. Please try to understand there is no number like hexadecimal number. The convenient way of representing the binary numbers are hexadecimal number, because these binary numbers, what we look in the screen, is very difficult to represent. So if you represent in hexadecimal number like this, it is very easy to say 0x84 instead of saying 1000000011. Instead of saying 1000000011, it is better to say 0x84 hexadecimal. So the convenient and the simple way of representing binary numbers are hexadecimal. Other than that, hexadecimal number does not have any significance. So binary is the main thing which is available in the memory. We are viewing that as a hexadecimal number in the memory location. But hexadecimal numbers are only binary numbers that we need to understand. This is very important with respect to 8-bit. Now coming to the characters, integers and all. When it is used as an unsigned character, means when we are viewing that 8-bit binary as an unsigned character. So if an unsigned character in paakumbodhu 0 to 255. Clear irukkudhungala? Now we'll come to the next slide. The signed la paakra mari paakalam. All ones, 8 ones are minus 1. 8 ones are minus 1. So when it is represented as hexadecimal number, it is FF. When it is viewed as an unsigned character, it is 255. But all ones are considered as minus 1 when it is used as a signed character. Similarly, 1110 is minus 2. Similarly, 111 FD is 253 if it is viewed as an unsigned character. And it is minus 3 when it is viewed as a signed character. Like this, it goes on.
7f is 127, and as long as most significant bit is 0, then it is positive number. Whether it is unsigned character or signed character, it is plus 127 only. But when the most significant bit becomes 1, all 1s are minus 1. When it is viewed as hexadecimal number, it is FF, and it is viewed as decimal number, it is 255. Similarly, FE is minus 2 when it is viewed as a signed number. When it is viewed as an unsigned number, it is 254, as we know very well. Similarly, you can see the screen, it is very much clear. And coming to 16-bit binary, in hexadecimal, we can represent it like this. One thing what we have to notice is, as long as the most significant bit is 0, it is positive number 32,767. And the most significant become 1, then it becomes minus 32,768. So the range of signed integer is minus 32,768 to plus 32,767. Always, it looks like positive number is 1 less than the negative number. This is not 1 less than the negative number because 0 comes under positive number. Hence, positive number looks like positive number is 1 less than the negative number. But both the positive numbers and the negative numbers are equal in case. So if you understand, very important why I'm doing this, because these are all very much comfortable, all of you know this very well. But why I'm just bringing this into the screen, because when we do any arithmetic operation, when we do any signed arithmetic operation, I can do 7FFF plus 1. Now you can see 32,767 is there in my bank account. In my bank account, I have the credit of 32,767. Because bank uses credit and debit. அப்போ bank வந்து signed integer தான் யூஸ் பண்றாங்க. Bank uses signed integer because bank uses credit and debit. So I have currently my credit is 32,767. If I am depositing one more rupee to the bank, and bank will say, customer, you have to pay 32,768 to the bank. If the bank says like this, how do we agree? So when the 16-bit binary, when it is viewed as a signed bit binary, signed number, so the maximum positive limit is 7FFF. But arithmetic unit does not know. So 7FFF plus 1, always it will become 8000. It is our responsibility to identify the maximum positive number has become maximum negative number. For example, 32,767, when we add 1, it will become minus 32,768 just by adding 1. So here we have to be very careful. So the maximum positive number will become maximum negative number when we add 1 with the maximum positive number. So to notify this, there should be some flag. That is what I'm trying to conclude. To notify this, there should be one flag. The overflow flag in ADT1 microcontroller is notifying the sign change while performing the arithmetic operation. While doing any arithmetic operation, if the positive number becomes negative number, as well as negative numbers become positive number, the overflow flag will set, and then it will notify that positive number has become negative number. That is the moral of the story. Okay. So similarly, if you see the screen, if it is an unsigned character range means, as you know, this is the range. And when it is unsigned integer range means, this is the unsigned integer range, as you rightly said. Here, what you have to see is minus 1 is all 1. If it is unsigned integer 16-bit means 16, 1 is minus 1. If it is viewed as a signed number, which is FFFF, it is hexadecimal number. And when it is viewed as an unsigned integer means 65,535. When it is 32-bit, 32 ones, right? 32 ones are minus 1, which is 0x. FFFFFFFF is minus 1, which is approximately 430 crore, 429 crores, 49 lakhs, 67,295. And the range of the 32 bits, the range of 32 bit is minus 214 crore, 74 lakhs, 83,648 to plus 214 crore, 74 lakhs, 83,647. It's quite interesting, no? That's the beauty of 8-bit, 16-bit, and 32-bit. That is the beauty of signed integer and signed numbers and unsigned numbers. That's all. Now you are very clear about the signed numbers and unsigned number. Fantastic, right?